It is declared that Mr. Jacob Zuma is guilty of the crime of contempt of court for failure to comply with the order made by this court in secretary of the Judicial Commission of Inquiry into allegations of state capture, corruption and fraud in the public sector, including organs of state, versus Jacob Zuma. Mr. Jacob for Mr. Jacob Zuma is sentenced to undergo 15 months imprisonment.
An unprecedented judgment that will be talked about for years to come. A panel of experts gave their views on the matter during a discussion facilitated by the Northwest University's Business School.
It is about Jacob Zuma, the former president. You can't separate the two from one another. It is a head of state who was brought before a commission to inquire into major misdemeanors during his term of office. I am pretty sure that in your lifetime and in my lifetime, we're not going to see a similar case again. The fact is that this particular case is unprecedented in our total history. I don't know of any similar case in any comparable jurisdiction. And God willing, may we never see another case like this. It is a unique case. And it was dealt with firmly within that context. If we have another case with similar outstanding exceptional facts, I'm pretty sure that the court would follow this precedent.
But did the Constitutional Court delay in dealing with the matter?
I think that it's widely acknowledged that within our justice system as a whole, speed is a problem, and many people have remarked on it, and I think we ought to be concerned about that, and I think we ought to be looking at ways in which judgments could be quicker. But I certainly don't, I certainly wouldn't point that finger at the Constitutional Court in the main. And I think Judge Crickler is right. I mean, you know, these are very often issues which are going to set precedents for a very long time. I don't think that the finger is being pointed at the fact that it took the court 3 months to decide this particular case.
And for some, politics can certainly not be divorced from the case.
When you're considering a former head of state who's about to be sentenced for a contempt of court, there's going to be politics. Constitutional jurisprudence is about politics. There's nothing wrong with that either. What is wrong is if people are acting from undeclared political motives.
And in recent years, the legal system has often been asked to adjudicate matters that speak to the alleged inadequacies of legislators and high-profile political leaders.
Well, the courts don't choose which cases they hear. Parties bring cases before the courts because they fail to deal with them politically, whether they be issues emanating from a lack of parliamentary oversight or internal political saga, such as we see with the suspension of Ace Makashule at the moment, which has landed up in front of the courts. Now, those are political issues, and the courts are being forced to intervene in those cases.
Deborah Pagedi, SABC News, Mahigeng.